Amarillo by morning, up from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I've got on. When that sun is high in that Texas sky, I'll be bucking at the county fair. Amarillo by morning.
Okay, hey guys, what's up? Today we're reviewing a 2017 Ram 1500 Super Crew Cab 4x4 Ecodiesel with a 3-liter turbo coming out of an Alfa Romeo.
Ugh, made in America. While Adam is, USA HLO Kitty Reviews is asking his daddy what size tires on this thing. Let's go through the interior here with my boots. Got pedals, gas, brake, emergency brake. You've got a horn, which we'll demonstrate later, and all sorts of great stuff.
Okay, so one of the first modifications we did to this truck was we put wheels and tires on it. Let's move down here. We have Open Country Extremes 295s all the way around, made in the USA.
Now, in order to stop this American beast here, we gotta have some sort of brake.
Hold up, Brooks. You know these are assembled in Canada, right?
Alright, in order to get this Prius to stop, we gotta have brakes. So we have EFI 290 18s disc brakes in the front. And if we'll move on to the back here. Canadian brakes. We have EBC 916s in the back.
Okay, so this has the Laramie trim level. Come with me. So the Laramie trim level is like, I wouldn't say entry level, it's above Lone Star, under Laramie Longhorn, then of course Limited. But we have chrome accented exhaust. Oh god dang, that's hot. We have chrome accented rear bumpers. We have debadged this truck, most of the badges on here. Let's move on to the side. We don't have any more 1500, and then of course that Ecodiesel thing. Yeah, but we can't offend any people around here. We have the chrome front grille. We have the...
Looks really
sadly,
nice.
Not until Rams were redesigned in 2018, which really was a 19. They still have the goddamn yellow bulbs. And then we have a chrome accented front bumper also, which is... God dang, listen to that. And moving on to this side, we have chrome accented door.
Open the door so they can see them.
Chill real quick, bro. Chrome accented mirrors. And then, of course, since this is an upgraded one, chill. We have the keyless entry on this truck. So if I just slip my hand with the key on, the truck just unlocked. Another brings me to the next thing. We have installed aftermarket steps.
That's what sex looks like right there.
AMP Research. They're pretty good. I believe they're mostly made for Rams. Cut it.
What?
So, like I said again, this is the Laramie trim level Ram. We'll show you the glove box. Is two of them. Okay, so we're gonna move on to the rest of the interior, but let me start the truck up first.
Listen to that power.
power the 3-liter turbo.
Okay,
so let's move on to the inside. Okay, so engine will not reset. Oh yeah, so that's another perk that you're gonna get with this video. We're almost out of DEF, and we're waiting until we run out of our warranty to take all the exhaust crap off. But in this video, you're gonna get to see us putting in this stupid stuff that America likes to call DEF. That's a joke for diesel engines. Like I said, we're moving on to the interior. This has a basically, I mean, it's plastic, but it's like a really nice accented gray piece of the steering wheel. You got the Ram logo and the you got the completely leather wrapped steering wheel, with which is also heated, and you have like your selections over here for the infotainment system. We'll move on to that in a second. And then we have like our cruise control and gear settings over here. Again, like I said, this is a, don't switch the gears. This is a keyless entry truck, and it does have remote start. So just a simple push on the brake and press the ignition. The all Rams, besides like the Tradesmen, which are weird and still have the nozzle up here, they're all the new pad now. And this is equipped with four-wheel drive. And of course we're running around in two-wheel drive because you're an idiot if you're driving in four-wheel drive on the pavement. And again, since this is the Laramie, you still have chrome accents everywhere pretty much in this truck. And I mean, the infotainment's basic. We did not get navigation in this because we don't need that. You got our phones for that. Then this does have the 10-speaker Alpine sound system in here with two tweeters in the front, a center, two big speakers back here. Then we'll move on to the back in a second. What's up, Brooks?
I mean, I'm thinking about how I turned on the heated steering wheel and you didn't notice.
Well, god dang. Wow, that actually is very hot.
That is really getting warm. Okay.
Let's just turn that off because it's 83 degrees out here. Yes, turn up that air.
Feel that power.
Climate. Thanks for turning on my hazards.
Yeah, there's the hazard button.
We're on low, and we got the AC cranked up all the way. That feels nice.
That really does.
Then, of course, let's move over here. We have our heated and cooled seats for passenger and driver, and we have our tow haul mode and traction control off. Let's just turn on those AC seats, because that's very nice. Right here, we don't have the optional $300 trailer tow package. This is where you would turn it on and off, and this is the switch to control your trailer. Then this is an option for an auxiliary, which that's not even offered in the 1500 lineup, which I guess Dodge is not good enough to make their own thing for the 1500. So let's just move on to the back, shall we? And so moving on to the driver's side, we have, of course, this is better freaking have power locks, and we have power mirrors and auto. The front. Let's just roll that back up. And then of course you have your dome control lights and then the auto headlights, which I guess we can move on to the infotainment system a little on the dash. God dang. We have like our coolant temp, trans temp, oil pressures. Then our economy, we've been getting 22 average. When we put on the aftermarket tires and wheels, before we put those on, we were getting 28 miles to a gallon and 29 on a good day. So yes, this went down 7 miles per gallon, but this is still above most entry trucks that are around this price range and that are the 1500 models. Just our trips and then Sirius. Then the truck is really pissed off at us right now because we are not giving it its DEF.
Show it the DEF gauge.
Yes, we're going to go back to the DEF real quick. So if this thing gets low enough and we bring it down to zero, this thing doesn't only go into limp mode, it goes into I will not start and shift gears. So basically what you have to do, I forget, there's a hack to this because if it's off, I can't switch the gears. There's something you have to do to mess with the computer to roll it in neutral, then I have to completely put the transmission in neutral also. And then you have to roll it back to the dealership a Ram dealership, well, Chrysler dealership, and then they will unlock it with the computer. So, freaking thank you, America, with your butthurtness of, well, frankly, I don't know.
Saving the economy!
So we got us our AC going at max right now. We're moving back here. We do have a few AC vents here. We have our heated seat options in the back, of course, not in the center. We only have a 12 volt back here, but what I did forget to mention, there's a full 125 watt charger in the front, which we're using for an optional phone charger right now. And this does have the two tweeters and two rear speakers and the sub. And then, you got anything to say else about this rear, Brooks?
It's actually surprisingly spacious. The last crew cab I was in was, you were sitting like this, and it wasn't very comfortable. This is the man spread edition.
So let's pop the hood of this Ram. Way easier to open up the hood than my Chevy.
Yeah. At least your Chevy has more props itself. You say that.
Here we go. It's a 3-liter turbo diesel V6 putting out 220 horsepower and 440 foot-pounds of torque. We have a green diesel tune on this thing, which adds about 60 more foot-pounds of torque and a couple tens of
lesbians.
Okay then. We got us our Ram intake over here. I mean, we got us some coolant, then all your other basic stuff.
Oh dang.
Rev it like America.
Just blew that out. What a liberal. Well, we lied. Because I guess that's expected from conservatives. We're out of DEF, so we're screwed.
We're not going to be able to go anywhere in 1,200 miles.
Yeah.